Now we're at the minuet. Suzuki actually took two different minuets and put them together to make one song. It says minuet one at the top of the first page and minuet two at the top of the second page, but it's not minuet one from book one or minuet two from book two. He's just labeling the which one comes first and which one comes second. Though, you ought to recognize minuet he's labeled one here, because you have played it. Though you're going to get some extra little thingies here. Do you see the kind of fat squiggle line with a straight line through it? That's called, I forget if it's called a mordant or what, but the general term is ornament. And if you have it without the straight line, you would play the note and then the note right above it as fast as you can. It's as if you were touching the stove and you don't stick around very long if it's hot. That's called a three-note trill, but I call it a one-bounce trill because that's how much on that I only bounce my second finger in twice. Here's a two-bounce trill. Well, you can do them down bow too. But you don't want to use a fast bow. If you use a fast bow when your fingers go fast, it just gets kind of messy. I'm using hardening bow, and I went to three. And it's very clear. Now, a long one, you might have to use a long bow because it lasts so long. But these go the opposite ways. Instead of going to the next note above, they go to the next note below. I've never seen that as a trill. I do believe it's called a mordant, M-O-R-D-A-N-T. And if you look at, well, there's some in each of these minuets. And what he did in small notes underneath, he wrote what it should sound like. Okay. Now, if you look at it too, the minuet on the first page is in two big sections, each of which repeats. Then the minuet on the next page is in two big sections, each of which repeats. And then it says DC minuet 1 al fine. DC is short for da capo, which means go back to the beginning. Go back to the DC, the beginning of minuet 1, not minuet 2, minuet 1. And you play until you get to the fine, or it looks like fine, F-I-N-E. But it's fine, it means finish. When you are playing on a DC, you do not do repeats. This is a standard minuet form. And I'm not going to do repeats because you can listen to your CD. Hop and glue the three. Hop and double up. Glue the three while you put down the four. Now, mordant. Double up. Mordant. Swoosh four. Now glue the three until you return. I have trouble with that one because it was probably stayed on longer to give a little oomph to the dissonance. Then you circle, hop and glue. Make sure your bow is going where it needs to go. Double rub. Four. Now glue the four until you return. That's the end of the A section, and that's when you repeat. It kind of sounds like you have a first ending in the middle, but you don't. It's just a resting place. Then you get to part B. I'm going to finish up part A. Then it's forte, so I'm going to use my whole bow. Swoosh. Stay. Now glue the three. Stay. C sharp. Now pull to the tip and stay their turns have been, I really think they're called mordents, but they go beneath, and this one goes above. Sorry. Okay. Then you've repeated A, you've repeated B. Now, I'm going to do the end of the B section for the second time. Now, watch my violin hand. Leave your three glued, but open up your hand so one and two go back and four winds up squeezing the three. So you are in the G minor fingering shape. And then you lift your bow and you play. Quartato, splat and slur. Through the three. How fast my up bow has been moving. It was moving fast back here. Smooth. Smooth. Okay, it was moving fast here. Smooth. Smooth. Swoosh. Why do you have to make sure your up bow is swooshing? I'm not saying swoosh on the down bows. It's a seven-letter word. It starts with a G and it ends with a Y. And the story is that somebody whose first name was Charles was sitting under an apple tree when an apple fell on his head. And he got to thinking about, well, why do things fall down? Why don't things fall up? And came up with a concept of gravity. As it comes to bowing, your down bow is almost always it's going to swoosh by itself. But you have to make it swoosh for the up bow. Or swoosh, 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 swoosh. Okay, now we're going into section D. And watch for the swooshes. Swoosh. Portato. Swoosh. Now slow down bow. Swoosh. You don't want to run out of room on that one. Hop and portato. Now leave room for another down. Blue jaw. Now, this is tricky. Splat the three. Now, you have your C natural down. Smush the three next to him. Move the three back to normal and a B flat. A. This is a big trick. You're going to want to practice this. You have your third flat. Splat. Set a bullseye. Smush. Return. And you notice I'm stopping in between every one to train. I'm training my fingers to fix between bows. Which means I have to stop. So they know to do that. And after you've done that about 5,679 times, you should be able to go. And make it smooth without messy. Then you're at the last phrase. Stay here. Forgetto. And then either if you're either repeating. Wait a minute. If you're repeating, I don't think I'd circle. Because it's not a big setup. But if you have. Circle. A lot of times in music you choose your bowing by what you're doing at that minute, but a lot of times you choose your bowing based on what's coming next.